What's that, Prince? This is what it sounds like when doves cry. Thought so.
How's it going, guys? Just not here with a... not Let's Play, but more of a I need to play a game and work some stress out. So, yeah, I'm just not having a very great day today. My brother, who lives with me, his lizard died. Very heartbreaking. Kind of had a loss for words, because he was very healthy until all of a sudden, instantly, he wasn't. Not helping bird. Bird woman. Whatever. Yeah, the...
Easy, ladies. There's enough Sam for everyone.
Sorry, you just can't drop Sam. Yeah, apparently they were... they opened up his tank to feed him, and he swam around, came out of the water, and then had a stroke or a heart attack or something, and just started twitching, and... Yeah, details aren't needed. Platforming in this game is so good. And it just went downhill rapidly. They tried to get him to a vet, and it didn't work out. Fuck off, man. So, I figured something really violent and fucked up would be the thing to do. I was gonna do Doom, the new one, but kind of feel like doing a Let's Play on that, and I don't really want to hop into it and just, you know, I don't know. I don't know what to say, guys. I'm just trying to have some fun and blow some steam, and I just felt like hitting the record button, I guess. You guys got a pet, give them a hug or a kiss, whatever you feel comfortable doing. Show them that you love them. If you've seen my videos, or if you look through my videos, you'll see a video where I feed them. Well, some of them anyway, the ones I could. And my brother's got a lot of them, but it's still a shame. I got a little pet of my own, little leopard gecko. She's great. Really love her. And we definitely experienced this before, because we've had this lizard a long time. His name was J.A.R, as in an acronym for Just a Replacement. I'll get into that later, I guess. In a minute, rather. Yeah, had him for a while, so it was just really sad to see him go. And before that, we had a long time ago, we had a lizard for a long time, a turtle for a long time named Ark, almost roadkill. As you can tell, we like our acronyms. God, I am doing really, really bad here. Mine's elsewhere, guys. Get dead. I don't know why I'm focusing so hard on this one fucking harpy that does not matter. Does not fucking matter. I can just walk right by her and that's the end of her. A lot of weird lag here. That's not the video stuttering. That's something to do with Serious Sam here. Maybe he doesn't like the recording software. Maybe I just hear. Yeah, Ark was a rescued turtle. We found him on the side of the road on the way to my cousin's house in Pennsylvania. You see my cousin, Geo the Hero. Yeah, years ago we were on our way to his house and there was a turtle in the middle of the road. Picked him up, threw him in the car. I think it was a wood turtle, is what they're called. It's been a really long time, but that thing was like a little puppy, and well, this lizard wasn't exactly the same thing, because Ark was in a pen shore, but not a... Oh, Jesus Christ, guys. I am playing this on hard. Probably not a good decision for this little distraction. Wow. Come on, guys. Get dead. Yeah, remember what I was saying about that harpy not mattering? She mattered. Gotta hit this thing real quick. Yeah, he had his own little pen outside So it's kind of different to the lizard, who had a more of a cage, I guess. But you know, you love both of them. Ark definitely was like a fucking puppy. This little wood turtle was in a little chicken wire fence outside. He had a little. Yeah, we don't care about the story.
Honey, I'm home.
Had a little pond to himself.
Jesus Christ, Sam, do you have to blow everything up?
Well, yes, I do.
As a matter of fact, I do.
So every time you walked outside, you'd see the turtle would see you out of his little house, walk over to greet you as far as he could anyway. He'd climb up the little chicken wire fence and then adorably fall over. It's always funny. Ooh, how's it going? And if you manage to get close enough with the food before he managed to get out of the house, the damn thing would walk over its food because it was so happy to see you. Oh, Ark. That was a very confused skeleton. A clear. Oh no. No. You don't want them to fire, they got a machine gun.
Oh, poor baby. Did someone step on your anthill?
That's a rude thing to say. Oh, Christ. Get dead. So yeah, Ark was a... That was a hard thing to take. Ark died of a disease that was kind of going through our island. A lot of reptiles were dying that year. I was back in the 90s. I assume it was in the 90s. It might have been like in the very, very early 2000s. But yeah, J.A.R. We've had him for a while. As I said, he's a replacement for another turtle. Turtle lizard. Yeah, sorry guys, I'm not gonna get out talking. Yeah, the lizard. He got to be a big motherfucker. He was huge! Hopefully, I'll slap a picture of him up real quick just to show you the giant ass that he became. Apparently, the vet was very impressed with the size, that they don't normally get that big. Big, beautiful lizard. And honestly, it was like a dog too, like a big puppy. I got that secret. Probably piss him off there, but I get the secret. That's okay. But yeah, it was kind of like dog-like. You can walk up to it and pet it. And despite being a really big fuck-off-sized lizard, it was really content. It was happy to get pet, and you can hand feed him. It's really nice. Yeah. Just a shame. You guys got any pets? Be sure to share in the comment section. Tell me what you like about them. Tell me what you love about them. If you had any pets and they passed, let everyone know. Talk about it. Want to keep it positive? Keep it positive. You wanna share something a little heartfelt? Go ahead. Lizard that we replaced is known as, oh man. That one actually slips my mind. I think I had a nickname for him, but I think I tried to put it in my head because we were going through a rough time when we lost that lizard. Oh fuck, what was his name? God, that hurts to have forgotten the name. I really preferred all the nicknames I gave to the lizards downstairs. It's really funny. The bearded dragon that we have down there, I call him Lieutenant Lettuce, because I keep putting a piece of lettuce on his head. And it always manages to keep it there for a good long while, so it's always funny. Oh man. But, yeah, the lizard that came before it, I'm slipping my head. I'm not good with names. Making me feel like an asshole, but there was a pretty big pet setup for him and the turtles that we had, but they were together for a good long while, and nothing ever came of it until one day, you know, like it got its tail nipped. So we're like, all right, well, let's separate them. My brother and his girlfriend decided to go out and grab something to separate the turtles from the lizard. And they got back, and the turtles fucking ate the damn thing. Not like they weren't well fed or anything, and they were like 10 minutes late too. So they wound up that day going out and getting J.A.R, and they named him just a replacement, just to keep up with the acronym thing. You know, it sounds like a mean thing, but nothing. It wasn't meant like that. We're just a very cynical family, I guess. You know, Ark and with roadkill and whatever. Probably a bit more creative than my leopard gecko, Zarzanagon. Her name, was kind of done out of, not spite, but like, my brother's girlfriend really doesn't name pets very well. Like, the other lizard they have downstairs is called Godzilla. It's not the most cliche thing. The hamster's name is Gizmo. Like, all cliche stuff. So I was like, I gotta name my lizard something really ridiculous. So I did. Bam! Boom. So Zarzanagon it was. And still is. Best little lizard you ever did see. The funniest thing is, like, I can see how someone could be scared of J.A.R. Because he was... God, I think he was around 4 feet long. Maybe three and a half feet long. But Zarzanagon is maybe 8 inches. And it looks like... She looks like she's always smiling. She's got this big smile, these big happy eyes, and people are scared of her. It's so funny. And it's ridiculous, too. The people who are scared of them, they all have cats. They're like, oh my god, that's a lizard. I'm like, yeah, it's a lizard. What's up? Oh my goodness, it's so freaky. Does it bite? Well, no. What are those marks on your arms? Oh, I got a cat. So, a cat that gives you actual scars is less scary than a lizard. Well, I don't know if it'll bite. It doesn't have teeth. You don't have anything to worry about. Or if it does have teeth, their teeth are too damn small to notice. I'm no zoologist. What do I know? God, this fall damage in a serious Sam game. How could that be? I didn't get the Serious Sam series till just before Serious Sam 3 came out. So, this was... Oh boy. Fuck. I only beat the first one with a friend, or the first encounter. I didn't beat the second encounter yet. But I beat Serious Sam 3, so I'm a little less familiar with the other games. So I wasn't aware of the blasphemy that they did from game to game. You know, fall damage and reloading. I haven't played Serious Sam 2 at all. I keep hearing it's not great, even though I've seen one or two people say they enjoy it. I don't know. Whatever. Pets. Pets are fun. Love your pets, man. Or lady. I don't judge. Except the little times I do. Shut up. Give me your neck. Yeah, Zarzanagon's actually my first pet. I didn't have a need for a pet for a while, but I went through a really rough patch where... I don't want to discuss too much of the stuff that's going on in my house, but I take care of someone who's disabled. And it was really, really hard. I mean, it's still fucking hard, but, you know... It was in the earlier stages, and I needed a pet. I really kind of just felt like I needed something. I was going back and forth between all these things. I was like, oh man, maybe a chameleon, that would be cool. But they don't live very long. Oh my god. Tell you what, guys, this might be the end of this video soon, because tell you right now, I let all these clears get by me, and once you Unless they get by you. It's a problem. Oh shit. Focus, not. Oh, that was good. That is not what I planned to use that cannon for, but. So, yeah, the fuck just exploded? Okay. Yeah, so I felt like I needed a pet, and looked at a chameleon, was kind of thinking about it, but found out that they're pretty aggressive. I don't like being handled very much, and I kind of wanted something I can hold or hang out with. The oddest thing is, JonTron really inspired me to get a pet, because he was always hanging around with Jacques on his shoulder. So I was like, man, I would love a pet like that, even if...
Get Sam.
Even despite all the problems there definitely are with a bird, or pet that would hang out on your shoulder, you know, pooping on your shoulder, you know, nipping you or whatever, I didn't care. I was just like, that looks like such a cool thing to have, I really wanted that. So I figured chameleon would be cool since they cling, but no, they're little bastards apparently, and my brother made the official absolutely no decision because fuck. He found out that they only live for like 2 to 4 years. He's like, no, you're not getting that. We need something that'll last because, you know, we don't need any more bullshit on your or my head. So I was like, alright, look, I just need something simple. I looked up something really easy. He asked around and he found a leopard gecko.
How do you like me now?
He found that leopard geckos are really easy to take care of and a great starter pet. And you know what? He ain't fucking wrong. The damn thing is the easiest thing in the world to take care of. I mean, cleanup is really easy because, you know, oh, lizards shed and everything. Yeah, but leopard geckos also eat their own skin. Yep, so once they shed it off, they eat it. So we were out one day, really stressed out this day. I was just like, fuck, I need a pet. I was just thinking about a pet in my head, just constantly still. And we were out, so figured, you know, let's go around, let's check out GameStop, maybe we'll grab some food, and we were near PetSmart, and he was like, yeah, I need to pick up some food for my lizard, so maybe we'll go in there. I warned him, like, Bri, if we go in there and they have leopard geckos, we're leaving there with one. And he's like, oh, well, you know, we'll see how it works. I'm like, no, you don't understand, we are leaving with one. They had them, and goddammit, I fucking left with one. We're getting pushed back pretty hard here. Fun fact about the kamikazes, you just take 2 bullets to get them, you go boop, stop, bang. Really effective way to get them to stop before they explode in your face. You don't want dudes exploding in your face. So I wound up taking her home that day. And the sad part is, she was stored in JAR's tank for the duration of cleaning out another tank that we had laying around. So, oh god damn it, JAR, why the hell did you have to die? So yeah, we got Zara Xanagon. Happy little nocturnal pain in the ass that she is. She hangs out on my shoulder all the time. You read a lot of things online, because some people are like, oh, not really something you can hold on to very long, they'll be very fidgety after 5 minutes and they want to get away from you. I've had her on my shoulder for like 2 hours and she's just totally chill. Now sure, she may have pooped, but whatever, it was worth it. Oh, this commentary is so sappy and lame. It should be more about screaming about killing dudes and smashing their faces in with hammers. Oh, but it's just really part of my head. And it's not really helped by a few months ago, another one of the lizards wound up dying because she was just not doing very well after laying eggs, I guess. I don't know. Wasn't doing well. Took her to the vet. They gave her some shots, for some, to help her out, you know, to keep her healthy and everything, and I came downstairs one day and she was dead. That was not a fun find either. Why do you want to post this? It's so fucking lame. I'm sorry, guys. Really, really sorry. Not sure the game's helping out too much either. We literally, 2 hours ago, buried J.A.R. inside of the house. Brother's girlfriend wasn't taking it well. Brother's not taking it very well. He's just a space cadet right now. You can tell by the look in his face, he's just not okay, and I'm trying my best to stick it out with him and hang out, and he's just, you know, I think he's right now just better off alone, and I totally understand that. Little scorpion fuck. The funny thing is, I really wasn't big on having, like, getting my own pet for, like, the longest time. It just kind of came up, because, like, you know, you read up online that it's a... Oh, I'm in a lot of trouble. You hear that, like, pets are really good at distressing you, and, like, not distressing you, like, relieving stress. There we go. That's the proper word for it. And, you know, it's definitely not wrong. So I kind of, like, figured, you know, I'll try that. Fucking looking for advice on the internet, kind of lame, I guess. But it wound up working out. Our Xenagon's great, happy little pet, like hanging out with her. J.A.R. was, you know, my brother's and girlfriend's pet, but you know, I definitely came downstairs to hang out with it whenever I could. Really, really wacky lizard. He was so big, you couldn't pick him up and really handle him. My health is not looking too good. No, this is not good. Oh, wow, what the fuck did I just get hit by? I really wanted to keep things positive on this channel, but it's just like... I really should just stop talking about it and talk about something else. Just at least finish up this level. But it's got a lot of negative sadness on my head. And my friends like Lou and cousin Gio tell me that venting is definitely a good thing, and I don't know whether or not that's true. I really like to keep my problems away from everybody, but I don't know, sometimes it just leaks out, or pressure becomes too great, and I'm just... I need something. I need someone to talk to, and it's like four in the morning, so I got no one to talk to. It's just me, the person I have to watch at night. And Clears. Unfortunately, Clears don't really listen. They just throw bolas at you. Kind of dicks like that. Well, in other news, positive news, I sold a sticker! Yeah, it's a little sticker. It's something that happens every once in a while. Got them up on a store page, and you know, I sold one. I'm really happy. And then I sold one recently, so that's good. I like that sticker. It is the embodiment of me. I don't care. I'll flash it up on screen probably right about now. Fucking hell, these things are making it hard to progress. Okay. So are these guys. Remember what I said about not doing that retarded thing that I was doing? Well, I did it anyway. Shit, there's gotta be health over here. They always spread health all over the place. Okay. Well, that health bar certainly had a lot more numbers attached to it in the past. Let's see if we can't increase that just a bit more. I also started a Redbubble account because I saw another artist that I follow on Twitter. Her name's Puka? I think that's how you pronounce it? I'm really sorry for this, how you pronounce it. But I saw her stuff on there and I was like, yeah, maybe I'll try selling some stuff on there just to share my stuff and get it out there, because I know people like buying silly, goofy things, and it's a good way to get your art out there, and that's really what I want to do. I want to make people happy. I want people to enjoy what I make, whether it's a really shitty Let's Play or my comic. It's just something that that I guess I'm continuing on from what my mother used to do. She used to sell clay figures, her own art, and she sold a lot of it, so I just want to make people happy. So I started a Redbubble account, I haven't really even announced it to anyone. It's just there, and it's got two stickers on there at the moment, but I'd like to get that going. Ooh, health. Man, I don't know what it is with this game, but certain things just launch you off if you're trying to jump on them. Oh yeah, aim down the sights. Another cardinal sin of Serious Sam 3. Did it piss people off? I don't see it as a bad thing. It's just there. You don't need to do it. It doesn't increase your accuracy or anything. It just zooms you in a bit. Yum, health. Oh, hi. Yeah, I'm playing as Sam. I thought I was playing as, what's her name? Serious Sammy? Or, I don't know, the blonde Serious Sam lady. And this is where things are going to get much more difficult. So if you thought my commentary was scatterbrained before, oh, wait till you see it now. I guess we'll get the super health kit now. That is, in fact, a lot of them. And there's one right above us. She's trying to jump down and swoop in. That's like fucking Duck Hunt over here. Well, if this was a Let's Play, I would certainly have to include the Duck Hunt dog here. Wow, not doing a good job here. That's good, stickers are good. I got a few more ideas for some fun stickers. One of them not very characteristic of me, because it's, I doodled it up. It's a Pokemon thing, kind of interesting. I don't normally draw Pokemon stuff. Not that I have anything against it. I actually like Pokemon quite a bit. There's a new one coming out, too. And don't mean Pokemon Go. How's it going, buddy? Boom! Hope you weren't walking too long just to get to that. We really gotta clear these harpies, because it's about to get a whole lot more crowded here. So yeah, I got a Pokemon thing, and it's really cute, and you know, nothing against cute, just that's something I normally draw. Not to that extent, anyway. And I'll hopefully find someone who'll enjoy that. If not, oh well. I'll cry about it some more. Other good news is I'm progressing pretty well in my comic. am a little worried because I've changed. I have a huge buffer with the comic, so I'm actually maybe probably like a year ahead in terms of content. It's not all finished, mind you, like all the pages that are done, in air quotes, done, need some word balloon work or like an effect or two added. But, you know, they're colored, they're shaded, pretty much done. But the comic that I'm working on, I'm a little worried about one thing. That's I've changed the style from the normal stuff quite a bit. So I'm hoping people take well to that, because it's made the process go a lot faster, I guess. It's easier to do than the painting style that I did. Don't get me wrong, I love the style that I used to do. It was nice, it was fun. It has an interesting look to it, but the way I do it now makes it just at least a little bit faster, and that's important when you're doing a comic as a hobby and you're not getting paid for it. Trust me, if I was getting paid for it, that'd be another story, but right now, I gotta focus more on a, quote, paycheck. I work at home, so it doesn't really work. I'm really just scatterbrained with this. And where is it? Yeah, so the new comic pages are coming up pretty good. I like the way the style looks, and it's just progressing faster than I was expecting, and I got a character design in that I was a little worried about. And I actually like it. I don't know, we bugged. Or is there a harpy stuck in some corner somewhere? Harpy. Oh, fuck. Trust me, you'll know when the event happens. It involves a spaceship. There's not the right spot, like. Oh, there we go. This was that. There we go.
Not enough room in this town for both of us, partner.
That ship is definitely inspired off of Mass Effect and their Reapers. Those are enemy spawners, so we want to kill this thing as fast as possible. I don't think those first couple shots I was shooting actually did anything. Yeah, these are the things I want to be hitting. Big difference, apparently. I almost blew myself up, just like I did before. I think what happened when I died before was I backed up and something just got, their hitbox just got in the way. I really need to get, whoa, boy. Did I hit it? Yeah, I did. Oh, that's not the right thing, damn it. I really need some more rockets. We got a couple of problems behind us, guys. This is not a game I've beaten alone. I've beaten multiplayer. Played with a brother. Quite a lot of fun. Yep, I know there's a lot of harpies around me, but you know what? As long as I don't hear any screaming, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be okay. Never mind, there's a lot of shit around me that's horrible. Actually, never mind, I think we're done. Yep.
All your baser belong to us, motherfucker.
Nice meme, Sam. Nice meme. Alright, well, thanks for joining me in this really somber and depressed thing. Hopefully it didn't depress you guys or drive you nuts. But I just really need to get this off my chest and I guess kill some bad guys. Since no one's around for multiplayer and whatever, I guess I just I guess I just needed this. But yeah, seriously, guys, post what. Tell me about your pets and stuff. Tell me about what you love about them. Tell me what they are, and maybe if you want a pet, say that too. And if you don't have a pet or don't want a pet, tell me about your Pokemon.